Good day to all of you. In the previous class, all of you learned about some of the options of the edit menu. In today's class, we will be revising all that we learned in the previous class. Can you tell if you remember all that you learned? In the previous class, you learned about undo, redo, cut, paste, select all, and find and replace. Can you tell why do we use undo and what is the shortcut command for it? We use undo to remove any word or other work in which we have made some mistake. The shortcut command for this is Ctrl plus Z. Can you tell what happens when we use redo and what is the shortcut command for redo? By using redo, we can bring back the word or other work that we had removed by using undo. Redo does the exact opposite of undo. The shortcut command for this is Ctrl plus Y. Can you tell what we need to do if we want to repeat the same line many times? In order to repeat the same line many times, we can use copy-paste options. What happens by using cut and what is the shortcut command for cut? By using cut, we can remove a line or a paragraph from its place and then using paste, we can paste it at another place. The shortcut command for cut is Ctrl plus X. Can you tell what happens by find and replace? And what is the shortcut command for this? Using find, we can search for any word in our document. And then by using replace, we can change that particular word. The shortcut command for this is Ctrl plus F. Now, all of you power on your computers and open the writer file. So, have you been able to open your writer files or not? If you are not able to open the writer file, then you must watch the video and learn from it. You can open the writer file in many ways. Today you will learn a new method of opening the writer document. This method is the shortcut command method. To open a file with a shortcut command, you must know the command for that opening. So first of all, you need to keep your left hand one finger on the Windows key, which is shown in the video, and press the R key. A box opens, which is the run window. In this, you have to, without giving any spaces, type out SWRITER. SWRITER. And then take the cursor or the pointer to the OK button and click on OK. Your writer document will open. In today's class, all of you will revise undo, redo, cut, copy, paste, and find and replace. Next, type out the shown paragraph in your writer file and then one by one revise the options being told to you. So first, practice the use of undo. If you face any difficulty, watch the video being shown to you and learn to use undo. With the help of this video, we will now learn how to use the undo command. For doing this, you have to take your cursor to the edit menu. Take the cursor or the pointer to the edit menu. Left click on that. And you will notice a box opens. Select the undo option and left click on that. You will notice that the last line which we had typed earlier gets erased. Now if you want to erase this once again, you can use the edit command, or you can also use the control plus Z, which is the shortcut for this. In the video, control plus Z has been used, and you notice that twice the lines have got erased. Now let us once again use the from the edit menu. So select that, go to the undo command, and you'll notice one more line gets erased. Once again, we go to edit, select the undo, click on that, and one more line gets erased. This way you can continue to keep erasing the last line that you had typed earlier. Let us now practice the use of redo. Again, if you face any difficulty, watch the video being shown to you and learn to use redo. Let us watch this video to learn how we can do redo. Redo is the exact opposite of undo. In the previous time, you had erased all the lines by doing undo. To do redo, bring your pointer or the cursor to the edit option, click on that, and then select the redo option. As soon as you click there, the last line that you had erased comes back. Again, go to edit, select the redo option, click there, the next line reappears. One more time, select the redo option from the edit menu, and the next line appears. If you want to use the shortcut command, which is control plus Y for redo, you have to do it here, and the next line reappears. To use the shortcut command, press the control button with your left hand, one finger, and then press the Y button, and you can see in the video, the next line reappears. You can keep using the from the edit menu and redo option to bring the lines back. Next, practice the use of cut and paste. If you face any difficulty, watch the video being shown to you and learn to use cut and paste. Let us now watch this video and learn how cut and paste are used. To be able to cut a portion of the text or the paragraph, you need to first select the portion, the line, or the text or the paragraph that you want to cut. So to do that, you can use any of the methods, either with your mouse or the touchpad, or with the shift key and the arrow keys. As is being shown in the video, we select the last three lines of this paragraph because we want to do a cut on this. Now take your pointer or the cursor to the edit menu, as is being shown in the video, and click on that with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad. A box opens and you have to look for the cut option and click on that. As soon as you click on that, this paragraph gets erased. Now let us see how we can bring back that paragraph by doing paste. So to do a paste, you can do a paste at any point where the cursor is on your writer file. Go to the edit menu, click on that, and then click on the paste option. You can also use the shortcut command control plus V to paste. So you see where the cursor was, at that point the paragraph gets pasted. Once you have cut the portion, you can paste it many times. So you, again, if you paste, the next line comes. So you can use the shortcut command control plus V, as is being shown in the video, and you can do the paste
a multiple number of times.
Now practice the use of copy and paste. If you face a difficulty, watch the video being shown to you and learn to use copy and paste. Let us now watch this video and understand how copy is used. So, to copy any text, line or paragraph, you need to first select the paragraph. You can select it using the mouse or touchpad or the shift arrow and the arrow keys. So, once you have selected the paragraph, as is being shown in the video, you can do copy either through the shortcut command or through the edit menu. So, go take your cursor to the edit in the menu bar, to the edit option, click there and then click on the copy option. The shortcut command for copy is Ctrl plus C. Once you copy, no effect will be seen, but it has been copied. Now, place the cursor where you want to copy the text once again, as is being shown in the video. And again, paste can be done in two methods, by using the shortcut command or by using the edit menu from the menu bar. So take the pointer or the cursor to the edit option and select the paste option. The shortcut command is Ctrl plus V. So you can now, once it has been copied, you can paste many number of times that you want. So you keep the cursor and use Ctrl plus V for as the shortcut command for paste. So this is how copy and paste are used. Practice the use of find and replace. Today you need to replace a word in the paragraph with your name. If you face any difficulty, watch the video being shown to you and learn to use find and replace. In this video, we will now learn how to do find and replace. In order to find any text, any word in your text or paragraph or line, you need to be able to look for that word. And it should be correctly spelled and it should be available in the text. So to find, you go to the edit menu and click on find and replace option. A box opens and you can see that you can type in the word that you are looking for or that you want to search for. And it also allows you to replace that word with another word of your choice. So to search for a word, you should type it correctly and in the correct spelling. Once you have typed the word, there are two options. One is to find, which will find the first time that this word appears in the text, or if you click on find all, then that same word, it will find all the words of that spelling which appear in the text. Like it is being shown in the video, we have searched for the word they, and all the words with that spelling THEY have been highlighted or have got selected. Similarly, if you want to replace this word with another word of your choice, you can do it with the shortcut command or you can do it through the edit menu. So you go to the edit menu and click on it and then look for find and replace. Remember, the shortcut command is Ctrl plus F. Again, that window will open which is for find and replace. Now you can type the text that you want to replace the word THEY, any word that you have searched for and you want to replace it with a new word. So let us say that the new word for us is Pranav, P-R-A-N-A-V. So we type the word here and if we click on replace, then it will replace the first time that the word day occurs. But if we click on replace all, it will replace all the words which had appeared when we searched for day. So now when you see in your text, the word T-H-E-Y has been replaced by the word of our choice, Pranav, at all the places where they had appeared. So this is how you can use find and replace. Go ahead and close the file. If you face a problem, watch the video and learn. In order to close the writer file, you will use the same method as you have learned for closing the paint file. So take your pointer or the cursor to the top right corner where there is a cross sign and click on that with the mouse or the touchpad using the left button. You see three options appearing in a window. Since you do not want to save right now, you can say discard, which is the middle option. Click on that with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad, and your file, writer file, gets closed. And then properly shut down the computer. Again, if you face any difficulty in shutting down the computer, learn from the video. Let us now learn how to shut down your computer. Bring your pointer to the start button as is being shown in the video. Next, use your mouse or touchpad to click on the left button. A box appears and you have to look for the shutdown option and take your pointer there. Then, using your mouse or touchpad, click with the left button and this will make your computer shut down. In today's lesson, we have revised undo, redo, cut, copy, paste, and find and replace. Thank you.